I think the stopwatch needs to start now, Roberta would like. For those who've got a vested interest. Catherine Arnold, Dr. Costley, parents, friends, and pupils of Holyoke School, welcome to our 2019 prize giving celebrations. This year, my address is going to focus on three key areas of Holyoke School year: creativity, adventure, and school initiative. I want to start this week with the words of possibly the youngest member of our school here today. Cohen wrote a poem that was highly commended in a field of 25,000 entries from within the UK. And it sort of starts my theme off rather well. Cohen.
We have the same uniform, we don't have the same skin. We have the same blood, we don't have the same eye colour. I like basketball, but I don't like homework. You like banana, but you don't like apples. Thank you for being my best friend.
Outcome of GCSE. So if they get a high 1.5 grades higher than her predicted data. That means if she got 2 or 3 grades higher than the data suggested she should have, that is astonishing. Now, our able learners aspire to the top, and they get there, getting results every bit as good, and in many cases better than I believe they could get anywhere else. However, the bigger and better picture tells so much more than these statistics ever will. I have endless stories of individuals for whom the school has thrown down the gauntlet of personal success, for whom we have encouraged the striving, provided a culture of hard work, supported the access arrangements, modified the curriculum, and most importantly, given a chance. We are proud of all of you, whatever your outcomes, not for the data, but for you and your very exciting futures. Clearly, our adaptive are far beyond the academic. We're aware that to be successful in life, grades alone are not enough. The most gifted people cannot thrive in life and in the workplace if they are not confident, if they do not feel good about themselves, if they cannot articulate their genius, and if they cannot give of themselves to other things. Holly Girk's culture is that all are encouraged to be involved, to take on responsibilities, to take opportunities on offer with joy. They can all bang their own drum. I wonder if parents ever really consider the other things that as a school we are obliged to teach, beyond these subject disciplines. Things like being healthy, being active, about the dangers of strangers, about public institutions and democracy, what it means to be British, study skills and online safety. We teach about looking after mental health and well-being, about managing money, and about giving career support. We aspire to fill all our young minds with positive values of kindness, tolerance, respect, courtesy, and hard work. We wish to develop the mind, the body and the soul in unison. Our elected pupils of the junior school will now tell you a little bit about their experiences. Lily and Matilda.
My name is Lily. Beginning of last year, I was elected head girl of the junior school. I've only been in this one for half the term, but I've already restarted biscuits and drink on a Monday for the start of the week. I've also introduced initiatives such as wearing coloured badges to represent our schoolhouses through juniors and seniors. I'm already thinking ahead and I have ideas, for example, organising random trumpets, year 6 leavers and benches for the terrace area in the junior playground. As ever, there are lots of opportunities for the juniors for children to become involved in the wider life of the school. Year 6 now join seniors each week for the house time, and it's great fun for us to be working with all the children and building our links before we move into year 7. We are also hoping to do many more fundraising activities together. Being head girl, even though just a short amount of time, has already been an honour, and I'm very proud of myself. I want to say a big thank you to Mrs. Keith and Mrs. White for all the help that I've received. I'm looking forward to the rest of the year to see what else I can get Mrs. Wright to agree to.
I am Matilda and I am the deputy head girl
My very part of the role is making new pupils' appearance and in the welcome in the junior school. I also enjoy handing out Star of the Week certificates, especially to the little ones, because they're very excited and proud of themselves. I enjoy attending Holygate School, and I find music, Spanish and PhD the most interesting lessons. I love singing in music lessons. With us in PhD, we are learning about healthy lifestyles. I love Holygate because it's a wonderful place for all pupils to both grow and have fun with teachers who are really kind to everyone.
Project was developed in part partnership with a parent, Dr. Alvarez, the Senior Principal Urban Design and Conservation Office of the Nottingham City Council, and focused on the Carrington Street Townscape Heritage Programme. 18 of our able pupils from year 6 to year 10 worked with external lead professionals to bring together technology and creativity by looking at the past, the present, and the future of the street. The showcase of their outcomes hasn't yet happened, it's coming soon in November. But what it's going to show are the following. A musical piece composed by Hollygirt pupils, based on the architectural features of the facades and the mathematics behind the designs. A literacy narrative, a design for a building that follows a Carrington Street trend with three-dimensional modelling software and a 3D design, with a piece of art and videography of the whole project. That is awesome. Dr. Alvarez sent a message to me just today, actually, and stated thus, this project, which is about to come to an end, is one of a kind, and I anticipate it will resonate in the field of architecture, urban design and planning as an innovative piece of work. It is rare for young children to be so involved in the long-term project of city planning. This group of pupils and teachers have certainly set an unprecedented ways of working excellence in their achievements. The project has shown the value of informing children about their environment and the ways in which they can make a contribution to shaping their city as citizens. I think if we have any accolade at all, Hollygirt tonight, that surely is it. That we are shaping our city with our pupils acting as citizens, working with green professionals. That is an incredible project, and thank you to all those people involved. It is Charlotte Newsom who tells us a bit about their experience in this project.
Organized a really exciting growing day. A lady came into school to tell us
Academy, and with Year 5 and 6, they also got the opportunity to do a more able and intense competing session to fly the drones.
We were split into small groups, and each member of the group had the chance to operate an iPad and set the programming instruction for the drone. The exciting challenge was trying to land it exactly on the post marked on the floor. Once we had mastered this, we also got to the drone to perform tricks like flips. I made one of the backwards flip. I really enjoyed the day because the drones were fun to fly and control. Thank you, Mr.
There were many other activities, such as absorbing, my favourite, archery, rat building, and attempting to create cattle. Together, we overcame fears and supported each other. It was an amazing adventure.
This summer, Year 7 to 11 had the opportunity to have a talk on the East Coast of America for a week. We went to New York and Washington, D.C., but were able to take in the sights, for example, the Statue of Liberty, the Martin Luther King Memorial, Central Park, the 9/11 Museum, World War II Memorial, and we also got to visit the White House. That's not all.
The 9/11 Memorial Museum is a memorial museum in New York City commemorating the September 11, 2001 attacks, which killed 2,977 people, and the 1993 World Trade Center bombing, which killed 6 people. One of the original staircases was still standing. This is called the Survivor Staircase. It has a big emotional impact. Two square rectangles in the centre mark where the Twin Towers stood, the Lincoln Memorial. The Lincoln Memorial is an American national memorial built to honor the 16th President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln. It is on the western end of the National Memorial in Washington, D.C., across from Washington. It features in the film at Lincoln Museum, more than 7 million people visit the memorial each year, including us. The Korean War Veterans Memorial. The Korean War Veterans Memorial is located in Washington, D.C.'s western Potomac Park, southeast of the Lincoln Memorial, and just south of the Reflective Memorial, National. It memorializes those who served in the Korean War.
We would like to thank Mr. Dean and Mrs. Howland for organizing this and all the merit help us owe them.
It's back to my creative thing now. In fact, it's actually time to take a break while we hear the Junior School musical items. So, over to the Junior School.
Leave your mind and
what a lot of words to learn. I think it's probably worth me pointing out off script again that earlier we heard the entire year nine with their drumming and their band work, and on stage the number before last was the entire junior school, year 3 to 6, singing for us. Later on in our program, you'll have the entire school and staff singing to you. Just keep in your mind the word inclusivity. It is really important to us. Back to script. Right, the rhythm of life suits my theme very well. At school we are timed in seasons, run by bells, which keeps the passing of time, or rather the utilising of time in a structured and action-packed way, going. Each new term, we see signs of growth in our pupils. And they also have the opportunity to start afresh if they need to reorder their efforts. And sometimes they've got new shoots springing out all over the place. Last May, the seniors, with some help from 2 year sixes, put on a heart-rending version of We Will Rock You. This apocalyptic vision of the future with no music in it hit us right where it hurt and made us, perhaps more than is politically appropriate, cheer for the freedom fighters. The cast were superb and the atmosphere created was just a perfect celebration of Holly Gert's crime. Jen Leeson will tell you a little about it.
I was in the school production of We Will Rock You. We Will Rock You gave me a great experience of what it's like to learn a script in a short amount of time. It was stressful, but it was worth it. I'm definitely going to do the next production that Mr. T puts on, and I hope it's just as good as We Will Rock You.
In this year's performance of We Will Rock You, I was privileged with the opportunity of playing the role of Scaramouche. This show has given me confidence in my singing and drama abilities. Even though the production was performed in our school hall, it was very professionally produced and I enjoyed every minute of it. We would like to thank the parents that put time and effort into helping the production of the show.
Juniors, with their many opportunities for performance and engagement and pupils' creative side, don't let us down either. What is impressive, as I said earlier, is that every pupil in school gets involved. Everyone gets a go. And this is really key to our success. Recently celebrating Poetry Day, this was again last week, all the junior pupils entertained parents with their class poems. And Oscar and Zeph are going to tell you a little bit about their entertaining efforts and their part of the action.
Last week, Junior School celebrated National Poetry Day by holding an assembly in which all of the children, from the very youngest to the oldest, performed in front of parents and teachers. There was a smorgasbord of poems, songs and performances. Performed a tribute to William Shakespeare, the nation's most famous playwright. My highlights were Lewis' saucy clay-grained clock hole. As a hard put upon a little beastly teacher, not dissimilar to Mr. Midway thinking about it, I had to send the errant schoolboys to the headmaster for acquitting themselves of the gurgle of feelings. The morning was a great celebration of the language of English.
This is our winning year 7 entry that Fionn read very first.
come, so feel free to be open.
Funny Looking by Anne Walter. At the hospital, on the day of my birth, I'm told I look strange for what it's worth. The doctor didn't whack my head like he did to others. Nope, I look so funny, he slapped my mother. So yeah, I wasn't a handsome guy. Mum said my face could make bunions cry. Dad took me to the zoo, and a girl made a crack. How nice of that man to bring the monkey back. Once I got sick with the cold and flu, I needed some medicine, like other kids do. The doctor was hardly a humanitarian when he suggested I visit a veterinarian. Being quite truthful, and indeed brutally frank, they turn off the cameras when I go to the bank. The first time I visit a psychiatrist, she insisted I lie face down on the couch. But I made it to college and earned a bachelor's degree, then completed a master's and a PhD, and I'm the owner and president of a large company where lots of good-looking people work for me. So if you don't like the image you see in your mirror, here's a message that couldn't be any clearer. Don't worry anymore, just tip the books. Because what you know gets you much further than how you look.
Reminding people that there are
and then my new boy, Mrs. George. Megan and I, see from year 4, will tell you about Sparkle Week first.
In January, we had Sparkle Week to raise awareness of mental health and well-being. During this week, everyone from nursery to year 11 made a real effort to demonstrate additional acts of kindness. Even something small, such as holding a door for someone, made a difference. Reducing stress, helping girls to feel good about themselves, and helping to reduce negative feelings and anxiety. We wore sparkly and brightly coloured accessories to school for this week, which allowed us to express ourselves.
Somebody that was always there to listen. And one particular person suggested that I was their personal cheerleader. I work in senior school and junior school alike, running nurture groups, meet and greets for students before school. I do drop-in sessions during breakfast, during break, sorry, and lunch, provide social support and developing skills and sessions wherever they are needed. Mrs. Crawford, our specialist one-to-one teacher, and I have just created our first sensory place, giving a calm place for children to retreat when things are getting overwhelming for them. It's such a great place for young children to be, and I'm blessed every day to be part of it. Thank you.
This is the area I think makes our school stand apart. Because of our independence, we can take a proactive stance and make a difference in young people's lives. Whilst many parents choose Hollygirt for the great education and the opportunities we offer in our calm and purposeful environment, others join us after struggling to settle, or in some cases, struggling to attend much bigger schools. And for some, just walking through our door and being smiled at, being known, being spoken to normally, our high expectations in the context of the support we put in place makes all the difference. I'd like to quote just a couple of short passages from parents who put pen to paper as their children would let them to school. Anonymous. We truly cannot thank Hollygirt enough for the encouragement, support, the style and approach to learning from all your amazing teachers. Our teachers are amazing because they are unstinting in their efforts to do their best for every child. Another wrote, with the dedication, care and warmth the school has shown my daughter, she has walked away with impressive results, feeling valued and with good friendships. What we do here so well, we do because we are small, because we care, because we can. We haven't got much of that family. we've got top quality people who genuinely understand all the young people need. Proactive attention, a listening ear, high expectations, clear boundaries, safety and love. And I'm saddened that these opportunities cannot be offered to every child who would benefit from our environment. And I urge our political leaders, all would-be leaders, to recognise the place of a small independent school in the national educational provision and to support our best endeavours for all those we can reach. As I close, I would like to thank my board of trustees, several of whom are in their first year of service, for the enormity of their efforts in supporting the school. To my loyal and endlessly enthusiastic, fabulous team of teaching and support staff, for you, the parents of the school, for entrusting us with the care and education of your children, and for this lot, the pupils themselves who are a veritable dance.